This is a simple example of a parallel circuit wherein we have three resistors. So we have still a 1 kilo ohm, then the second and the third resistors have a value of 1.5 kilo ohm. So they are connected to a 5 volt voltage source as shown here. So this is one conducting material, one straight conducting material, as well as this one. So for this case, we expect that for all the resistors, they have the same difference in potential, or they have the same voltage across their ends. And that is one of the characteristic of a parallel circuit. Also, the total current for this circuit is the sum of the current that will pass through each resistors, as shown here. So let's try to run this simulation. So there you go. So this is the circuit diagram for our parallel circuit example. Let's try to build this part of our circuit diagram. So this three resistors. Okay, so we know that in the circuit diagram, this refers to a 1 big conducting material. Same goes with this one, so this is a 1 conducting material. So given that in our breadboard, this refers to 1 conducting material connected internally, so what we can do is to connect the ends of our resistor along this point. So I can place my first resistor here, then my second resistor, then my third resistor here. So that's it. That's very easy. That's how you connect your parallel circuit as shown in the circuit diagram. Then you can connect your power supply, the positive part, somewhere along this row or this part of your breadboard. Then the negative part of your power supply somewhere along this conducting material. So I have again 1 kilo ohm resistor. Then I have here 2 resistors with a value of 1.5 kilo. So I'm going to use again this breadboard to create that circuit. So first, I'm going to connect one end of my resistor 1, which has a value of 1 kilo ohm, at somewhere here at row 36. Then connect this one at row 29. I'm going to connect one resistor again with a value of 1.5 kilo ohm here at the same row as the left side of my 1 k ohm resistor. So I'll push this one here. Then I'm going to place the other end here at the same row of my of the right side of my first resistor. So I can say now here that my first resistor here, 1 k ohm, is parallel with this second resistor, which has a value of 1.5 kilo ohm. Now, I'm going to connect this one again. I'm going to place this one at the same row of these two resistors. Okay, so that's row 36 here. Then I'm going to place the right end of my third resistor at row 29. Same row as with the right sides of my first two resistor. So there you have it. So this circuit shows how to create, this circuit shows three resistors that are parallel to each other.